Sweden, and we do this show each and every day at 8 a.m. Central European Summertime, guys. What an amazing day. What an amazing market. What an amazing economy we're living in. Really, it is the crypto economy. And it is amazing to have you guys here. Today is going to be an extremely juicy, content-full stream. We have so much to discuss. First of all, I want you to discuss the following. We're going to talk about predictions for the next bull market. And the next bull market, in my view, is going to be between 2019, this year, and 2023, as you can see on the screen. We're going to discuss why I have chosen these years and why I've chosen 4 years for this bull market. And really, where can we go in this bull market in regards to Bitcoin, in regards to Ethereum, and also in regards to altcoins? Because obviously, many people are now sitting in altcoins and they don't really know what to do, because their altcoins are losing dominance against Bitcoin. Bitcoin dominance is really going through the roof, and many people have a lot of questions about altcoins versus Bitcoin versus Ether. So we're going to discuss that. Then we're going to discuss the fact that the markets are getting more efficient. The markets are getting bigger, the markets are getting more mature. And what does it really mean for crypto? And what does it mean for us long term? Because just yesterday you saw the news that the first ever crypto settled futures contract will be rolling out soon. So there is actually an approval to do crypto settled future contracts. And we will discuss why it's so important and why crypto settled futures contracts are so much more better for us in crypto compared to fiat settled futures. This is very, very important. So this is something we're going to discuss. Then, of course, we have big news from Asia, from Walmart China and VeChain. This news came out yesterday, and I really wanted to get confirmed by Walmart and everyone else involved. Really, it's a collaboration between Walmart, between PwC, and between VeChain. So these three companies are right now gonna deploy a product that is gonna be used for tracking food in Walmart stores. And even Walmart confirmed that this is gonna be for real, and they're not just collaborating as some kind of theoretic partnership. This is real, and they're actually using this technology right now. So very important stuff. And together with that, we're going to take a look at the code of VeChain and really what they're doing and what is happening. So guys, amazing to have you here. Amazing to have you here. I see the chat rolling. I see Ruslan. I see Pale Girl, I see Max West, William Poole, Kelts, Egbert, everyone, extremely welcome to the show, extremely welcome to the stream. Number one, smash that like right now, smash the bell right now if you think that Bitcoin is going to continue to pump and going to continue to go up, and if you're excited for this whole movement. And of course, maybe the most important thing you can do right now is to share the stream, because your random Facebook friends need to see this. They really need to get informed about what is happening. Also, guys, this bull market is gonna be very, very significant. And for you to leverage it, you need to have extra information that we're going to give you for free in our webinar. So really, thanks, man. Thanks for donation. Dr. One, my man, thanks. So if you go to academy.iventank.com/webinar, you can find in description, you can join this webinar if you have not been on the webinars before. If you have been on the webinars before, you will recognize a lot of things. But if you haven't, this is really your chance. Now, guys, you know that we actually reached 13,000 for one Bitcoin on Binance. Originally, I was gonna talk about whether we will reach 13K today on this stream. This was my plan from day one. But then when I woke up, Bitcoin was at 12,700. And if you actually watch at Binance, Binance crossed 13K, or at least touched it. It's difficult to see, but at least it touched it extremely, extremely closely. So we see so significant strength in the market right now. And what does it mean? What does it really mean for the markets? Something else that is significant is just the entire dominance right now. If you go and you look at Bitcoin dominance, you see that the dominance is really pulling away from altcoins. And right now we are at approximately 62% Bitcoin dominance. And this is something that you see more and more happening right now, that Bitcoin is gaining a larger and larger share of the market. And in my view, this is only going to continue. And if you can see historically that Bitcoin has been going down in dominance for a very long time, especially at at the end of the last bull run, because everyone who got rich in Bitcoin started to diversify into altcoins. But now we see a reversal happening. So as you can see, it is starting to go up again. And this is something that we need to keep an eye on, because the Bitcoin dominance really tells you where we are in the market. It really tells you where we are in the cycle of the markets. And so when the Bitcoin dominance is going up, it means that we're early in a bull market. It means that people are excited about Bitcoin and they haven't started to diversifying into altcoins yet. They did not start to sell off Bitcoin yet. Nice man, Scotchman, thank you so much. I appreciate you. Thanks for donation. Looking at the markets as a whole, we see the following situation right now. Bitcoin is at 12.5k. It was at 12.8 just a few minutes ago. It's really, really, really volatile market we have right now. Ethereum plus 5% at 330. Ripple plus 1%. Nothing has really happened. And so something interesting you see in the markets right now is that really Bitcoin is pulling ahead, as we mentioned, but also a few altcoins are also doing extremely well. So if you just look at VeChain, that we're going to cover later on in this video, they are also pulling ahead quite good. And if you just look at the past day with the whole Walmart thing, they pumped 30% yesterday. So you realize that there is Bitcoin, there are altcoins. Bitcoin is gonna pump even without any major announcements. I mean, it's all about market psychology. It's all about FOMO at this point in time. Nice man, Oscar. Thanks. But when it comes to altcoins, they really have to deliver. For an altcoin to pump today, you really have to deliver. And really, Walmart was a huge announcement for VeChain, but still, they only pumped 30%. It's not like they pumped 100, 200, 300 or whatever. They did not really reclaim a lot. If you really look at the big picture, you see that they did not really reclaim that much. They reclaimed quite significant amount, but really, is historically, we've been so higher in VeChain. So maybe it's only the start, but I just want to communicate to you, even with the world's biggest announcement, still, you're not guaranteed a huge pump. You're not. Maybe you can get 30%, and it's amazing. I think it really is the best you can get in this market as an altcoin right now in our cycle. So just something to keep in mind. So while everyone is feeling happy, you're feeling happy, I'm feeling happy, we could potentially go to 14k today. Thanks, man. That Lee. Thanks, man. Donation. We could potentially go to 14k today. It's not impossible. Absolutely not impossible. But we also need to discuss this situation with calm feelings. As I always tell you guys, keep your FOMO in check. And this is where now you're gonna see so many people FOMOing in and trying to buy Bitcoin and get into Bitcoin. And it is, of course, important to discuss the possibilities. So looking at this bull market that we're entering right now, I do think that it's gonna be approximately 4 years. Because if you look at the past bull market, we really started in 2016. So we had 2016, 2017, 2 years. Maybe you could argue we started in 2015 even. So 2.5 years approximately. So my bet right now, not financial advice, but my bet right now is that the markets are gonna get longer. The cycles are gonna get longer. You look at the traditional finance space, you look at the US economy, for example, usually have 10 years between boom and busts. You have approximately 10 years. That system is obviously very different. That system is fueled by debt. And really this boom and bust cycle is because of debt. And if you do not understand that, you need to go and after this video, watch another video called How Economic Machine Works, and you will understand it. In Bitcoin, you do not have these boom and busts because of the debt cycle. But instead, you do have the psychological aspect to it. The fact that we're still discovering the price. We don't know how much one Bitcoin is worth. My long-term prediction for Bitcoin is 380,000, because this is the market cap of gold. Market cap of gold is 8 trillion, so it is not impossible that we reach that. I mean, honestly, can we reach 8 trillion with Bitcoin in 20 years? In 10, 20 years? Maybe not in 10, but in 20, absolutely possible. So this is something to keep in mind. How do you view it from a macro perspective? From a macro perspective, I'm looking at 380k. From a absolutely macro perspective. Now, is Bitcoin, thanks man, is Bitcoin more worth than gold? Probably. I mean, that is the thing. It has possibility to be worth more than gold. Why? Because gold is only for storing value right now. Sure, it is used in industry. It is used in some other aspects as well. But mostly it is for storing value. That is the number one thing. Mostly it is for that. And you realize that there are so many companies around gold. There are so many companies guarding gold. There are so many companies transporting gold. There are so many companies that are custodians of gold. And you realize that Bitcoin can really replace all of them as well. So the value of Bitcoin should not only be compared to the market cap of gold, but it should be compared to the market cap of gold plus the whole ecosystem around gold, all the market caps of all the companies that store, transport, and make sure that you can actually do gold investments in a reasonable fashion. So this is something to keep in mind, and many people don't realize it. Like, gold is amazing, but Bitcoin has so much other things built in, like, for example, the transportation layer, like, for example, the storage capabilities. All of that is baked in, so very important to realize. At the same time, I don't think that we're gonna reach 380k in this bull market. I think we're just too early. Now, I might be wrong. I might absolutely be wrong. We might be going there quicker than I think. But to reach 380k, I think we will require a few more bust and booms cycles. So I think it's gonna take some more time. But looking at this bull market, is 100k possible? Absolutely. This bull market from 19 to 2023, we can absolutely reach 100k. Not financial advice, but I do genuinely believe so, because look at the past bull market. I hope I say bull market. Sometimes I kind of switch them. But of course, in this bull market from 19 to 23, we might reach 100k, because if you look at the past bull market, you realize that we went from 1k, I mean just 1k of the past all-time high, to 20k. We really saw a mind-blowing increase. So for us in this bull market to go from old all-time high of 20k to new all-time high of 100k, it might look even conservative, because last time we did 20x from all-time high to the next peak, and this time from 20k to 100k is just 5x. So I think this is also a nature of the markets, that they're getting bigger, and therefore the cycles are getting not as violent in terms of percentages. So something to keep in mind. But at the same time, you need to realize that we're all in one way or another lunatics. You and I, we're all lunatics if we are in this market. I mean, we're all playing with fire. Let's just say that. We're all playing with fire. And in many cases, we are actually lunatics. So look at me, for example. I quit my job to do crypto YouTube. I mean, what kind of lunatic would do that? I mean, if you tell it to your mother, hey, mom, I'm gonna quit my job as a programmer, as a developer, where I have my career laid out, and I'm gonna go talk about Bitcoin on YouTube, and it's in the middle of the bear market in 2016-17. It sounds completely insane. And even when you invest in Bitcoin and crypto, you're also in many cases lunatics, because we might see 80% corrections. And we might see 50% corrections. But that is the only way today to really make a difference in your life. And thanks man. Because the only way to truly get a lot of return on investing is really two things. Number one, you can invest in startups, early startups, but you are probably not an accredited investor. So when all of these guys like Uber, like Slack, like WeWork, all of these guys who do IPO right now, all of their venture capital and seed investors, they're doing 100x, 200x, 300x, it's not impossible. Thanks, man. They're all doing this 100x's. And obviously, you as a normal person, the only thing you get is the IPO price. And you start trading on IPO price, and everyone has already dumped at you. Everyone has already exited their positions. So you realize that this is completely rigged against you. So crypto is only the only way for people to get involved in this 100x, 200x, 300x scenarios. And right now, it is obviously very risky. Thanks, man. It's obviously extremely risky, but that is how venture capital also is. You lose in 9 of 10 cases. You lose money in 9 out of 10. So this is the same with crypto. It really gives you more freedom to be involved in things that are more volatile, more risky, but also have high return. So it's all about how you are as a person. So this is something very important to mention, that while we are all excited, keep your FOMO in check and realize the downside as well. But at the same time, if you're cool with your risk, you're cool with the downside, no shame in being excited. This is the thing people tell me. Hey, Ivan, you do too much FOMO. You're too excited on your channel, they say. Hey, Ivan, you shouldn't be as excited. Be more non-exciting. But guys, at the same time, it's important to realize, as long as your FOMO FOMO in check, as long as your risk management is in check, it is time to get excited. Because if it is not now, I don't know when you're gonna be excited, to be honest with you, to be completely honest with you. Man, donations keep piling in. Thanks, man. Very happy for all you bear market survivors. Yes, man. I've been doing this show each and every day, entire bear market. So while we see amazing improvements in Bitcoin, in the price, everything is going up, there are some worrisome information as well. I mean, one worrisome information is the fact that Tether is pumping as hell in terms of market cap. So people are really correlating this past rise in the price of Bitcoin with the rise in market cap of Tether. Heroes to use leverage. Man, be careful. Being in crypto, you are already a big lunatic. So be careful with leverage. If you know how you can manage risk, then fine, but be careful. But anyway, you see that it highly correlates with the rise of Bitcoin, the market cap of Tether. That in April, in the beginning of May, they started printing more and more, and then the whole thing is just continued to rise, just like the price of Bitcoin. So many people are a bit worried that this is caused by Tether, but at the same time, it's also difficult to see what causes what. I mean, is it Tether that causes Bitcoin to pump if they just print money like crazy? Or is it the increase in the price of Bitcoin that causes more people to deposit funds in Tether? And then, of course, the market cap of the coin will rise as well. You need to understand that there are so many things that can go wrong as well. I just want to bring it up to you. But then we will have more positive news in this stream as well. I have more positive news than negative. Something else that you need to keep an eye on is this huge transaction of 8,800 Bitcoin going to Coinbase. So why would you move funds to Coinbase? Well, either you want to sell or you want to switch to altcoins, these two probabilities. And who knows really what will happen? I mean, if you sell that many Bitcoin, you can definitely move the price a lot. And at the same time, if you are a big institution, as this article probably claims they are, the article says that this transaction was probably from a custodian or financial institution, then they will probably be more smart and they will sell it in a way that doesn't move the price as much. But just something to keep an eye at the back of your head, we have some clouds on our blue Bitcoin sky, at our blue Bitcoin sky, and with our rocket we're ready to go to the moon. But please guys, be careful as well. Who knows how exactly this is gonna be played out and how long you can stay in the market, even if we drop to 7k, 6k. I mean, could happen. Once again, could absolutely happen. But long term, you know, not financial advice, long term 380k is my target, at least. Because as I told you, this is a market cap of gold and Bitcoin does so many more things than gold. Very, very important news that I wanted to discuss with you right now is this CFTC approval. Basically, they approved a crypto settled futures issuer, which is called Ledger X. Thanks, man. VeChain. We will get into VeChain. So this basically means that Ledger X will be able to issue future contracts that will be settled in Bitcoin. And you know that this is not new. I mean, future contracts for crypto is not new. We have been seeing them in the past as well. And all of them previously have been settled in fiat. So that you can buy a future contract and when it expires, you do not get the amount of Bitcoin, but you get the dollar amount that is correlated to that Bitcoin amount, that maps to that Bitcoin amount. But this means that each time a contract expires, the issuer needs to sell Bitcoin, because you as a customer, when you are a customer at this and you buy their futures contract, you need to get paid in dollars at the end of the day. And obviously you as an issuer, you need to get Bitcoin, you need to hold it because you don't know how the price is going to behave. So you need to have your collateral. You basically need to have the assets that you're building your financial instruments around. And when the contract expires, instead of just giving Bitcoin to people, you need to sell it and then you give dollars. So by having fiat settled futures, you actually create a lot of sell pressure that is not needed when you actually settle contracts in real Bitcoin. So this is very important, and this is a very important news that many people are overlooking right now, that CFTC approves Ledger X futures. FOMO into donations. Yes, sir. Time to FOMO into donations. Now, let's move to Walmart and China, and let's move to WeChain, because WeChain now have a collaboration with Walmart. It is confirmed 100% by Walmart. It is confirmed by PwC, and this is something that I personally was waiting for. I wanted all of the big guys to confirm it before talking about it, but it seems to be confirmed. So this is a big day for everyone holding WeChain, at least if you held recently, because the price increased 30% after this news yesterday. And so the important thing here is that Walmart China, PwC, and WeChain are now collaborating on this software that will be tracking food in China. And it is important to note that the situation in China is very different from the situation in the Western world. In China, you actually need to know where your food is coming from. In the Western world, you don't really care. You go to the store, you buy it, it works fine, it tastes good. Most probably you will not get killed by salmonella or some other bug in your food. Most probably it will not happen. Could happen. I mean, I'm not telling you it will not happen. Could happen, but in China, the chances are just higher that it will happen. And the people are dying and getting sick from food poisoning to a much larger extent. So really, this announcement shows you the speed and innovation of Asians. Really, Asians are so good at adopting things right now. You look at mobile payments, you look at WeChat, you look at blockchain, you look at Bitcoin mining. Really, Asia is the number one market for everything right now. They're really, really good at adopting and starting to use things technologically. And why are they doing that? Well, because they have more issues that technology can solve. And when they have more issues that the technology can solve, for example, the fact that they do not have any credit cards or debit cards, instead they have only WeChat. So WeChat really took people from just paper money to digital money, and they skipped the credit cards. So is now with food and tracking of food, because they go from something, from a bad place to a good place. While we in the Western world, we're kind of in between. I mean, we do have credit cards, they're working fine. People don't really understand the point of Bitcoin, of, you know, of paying in apps, of paying through a system like WeChat. People don't really understand that, because we have things that are working kind of okay, but they could be better. So the incentives for us to grow, the incentive for us to really show how new technology should be used is very small. And that is why we're lagging behind. And this is why East and West really go back and forth through the times. Because when the Western countries are doing well for themselves, like in the past 50 years, or maybe even 100 years, you can say, you're getting relaxed. I mean, you're getting relaxed, you get socialism going, you get welfare for everyone, and you're just getting complacent. And that is when East comes and snaps you out of your position. Whoa, man, this is $99. I didn't see it actually, but thanks, man. So, something to keep in mind. Something else that is important is to follow Sunny Liu on Twitter. So just go and follow him. He's the CEO of WeChain, and if you want to learn more about what actually happens and their announcements, this is the place. But now I also wanted to talk to you a bit about the WeChain GitHub and really what they have going for them here, and really look at the fundamentals, because at the end of the day, it's all about fundamentals. It's all about how do you use your team, how do you use the technology, how do you use your resources in the best possible way. And when you are evaluating projects, you need to be looking at their GitHub. So looking at WeChain, you have a few things here. Number one, you have Thor, which is the actual protocol. This is the implementation of the protocol, of the node, okay? So here is where you have all the consensus rules. Here's where you have the networking. Here's where you have all the definitions of the different data structures, of different data types. And really, this is the application that makes WeChain work. This is the application that is basically your Bitcoin full node, but kind of WeChain full node. So this is very important. Next, you have Connex. Connex is also extremely important repository on WeChain page. Why? Because this is how dApps communicate with this node right here. Basically, when you create a dApp, you have this application that is running in a decentralized fashion, but it needs to communicate with the blockchain. It needs to have a standard way to talk to the blockchain and to get information from the blockchain, to put information to the blockchain, and to interact in different ways. So this is really the library that allows you to easily integrate your dApp with Thor. So this is called Connex. And also, because it is in JavaScript, it is for web technologies. I mean, it's all about web technologies at the end of the day. So Connex is also used as a web library. So you have your website, you can integrate Connex. You can then, by doing that, make your website communicate with the VeChain blockchain, but also with the user. So very important. So those are the two most important libraries to keep in mind. But then you also have a lot of other things as well. If you go down here and you take a look, but those two are the ones I would focus on if I were you. Now, going on to the actual protocol repository, first of all, need to understand that it is written in Go. So they're using Go programming language to do it. Why are they doing that? Why not C++? Why not C? Why not C sharp? Why not something else? Mainly because Go is Google's modern programming language. It is, I think maybe it's 10, maybe 15 years old. I don't really remember by now, but it is kind of new. You compare to C++, you compare to C, Go is very new programming language. And it has the performance and the low levelness of C++, basically that you can run code very close to the hardware. You can really optimize your software a lot. And this is why many people are using Go nowadays, because it is easier to write in, it is harder to make mistakes, but you get the same kind of benefits of C++. So this is very important. Looking at the insights, here's where you go to the insights, and here's where you go to the contributors, you can see their development, the development pace. And as you can see right now, they do not have a lot of things happening in the past few months, at least when you go and you look at insights at their main page. But the main bulk of work happened in 2018. So the whole 2018, the first half of 2018, this is where the protocol developed the most. And now they're still working. You can see they're still active, but not as much when you compare to the old times. And I think it is also natural for many projects because you only do the bulk of the work once. I mean, like in Bitcoin, Satoshi did everything, had a huge commit, like boom, and then you have a small work happening afterwards. So if you just zoom in here, you see that they're still working, it's still moving forward. Looking at the past year from 2019, you really see two main people working on it. Is this guy Qian Bin? I don't know how to say it. Qian Bin, is that, or Qian? Whatever. Sorry for butchering the name. Is this guy and this guy. So looking at this, now it seems like they only have two people. Of course, they have a few other ones, but it's not a lot. At least working at the main protocol. Then you also look at their Connex library, as we mentioned. There you might see more. Let's see. Let's go to VeChain. Let's go to Connex. Let's go to Insights. Let's go to Contributors. Let's see. And the past, yeah, they really started working on this in the past year. And here you see kind of the same guys, Kia Bin and Li Bo Toy. Let me know if this is how you pronounce it. But anyway, guys, this was the main thing I wanted to communicate to you. And let me see if I did not forget anything. I just want to reiterate this fact about the bull market that is happening right now. And you remember I told you that it's going to be from 2019 to 2023, and the fact that the target long term is 380k because of gold. In this bull market, I don't think it's gonna happen. I think we're gonna go to 100k approximately, because and this is my conservative estimation, because we will go 5x from the past all-time high, and it's completely possible because last time we went 20x from the old all-time high. And looking at the most important ingredients in this bull market, what are the most important ingredients? Number one is, of course, the fact that we do have real-world adoption, such as VeChain. Why do you sound Chinese? Because these guys seem to be Chinese. So I try to tell their names in their native tongue, as you know. I'm a very international person. So when I see a guy, I try to tell his name in the native tongue. So let me know how to pronounce the Chia Bin or something else. Let me know in the comments. But anyway, number one ingredient is real-world adoption, such as VeChain right now with Walmart. Number two ingredient is DeFi. Look at what's happening to MakerDAO. Look at what's happening to DAI. Look at what's happening to Compound, for example, that you have loans and lending on the blockchain in a decentralized manner. And really, you need to keep all of these things in mind. Number three is, of course, store of value. And the more people understand Bitcoin, the more store of value features it gets. The more valuable it is in the eyes of the people, the more it is suitable as a store of value. So these three things are very important. Store Value, Decentralized Finance, and Real World Adoption. Fabrice. Nice. Fabrice going wild. And finally, it's all about daily transactions. I mean, will we see daily transactions with Bitcoin or Ethereum in this next bull market? I mean, probably not to the extent that that is possible. Probably not, because as I told you, most people in the Western world are not going to use it for daily transactions. Most people in Asia are not going to use it for daily transactions because they have WeChat, and the fiat system is very efficient right now at daily transactions. So while we do have Lightning Network, while we do have the possibility of doing daily transactions, it is simply not the use case that matters to people in Asia and Western world. For now, it's mainly store of value, escape inflation, and make money, because people are excited about it. So just looking realistically at the ingredients of this bull market, I would say that those are the ingredients. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. We're going to round this stream up right now. I just have a final message from our sponsors, Bitstack. You know that we had Bitstack on the channel a few weeks ago. Now they have an update for you, what happened since then. But for me, guys, I'm out. Thank you so much for watching. Now let's watch the video from Bitstack. It's gonna be approximately 5 minutes. And after that, I will see you all tomorrow. I'll see you all at 8 a.m. Central European time, as always, like an atomic clock tomorrow. Now, let's go. Let's roll Bitstack. Let's roll the ad, and see you guys. Goodbye. Okay, guys, I want to give you an update on Bitstack, because you know that we had an AMA with the CEO of Bitstack a few weeks back, and Bitstack is this new exchange that is getting quite a lot of attention. And something interesting with Bitstack is the fact that they are collaborating with Bittrex. So from a backend perspective, this is quite interesting, because they do have a joint order book together with Bittrex. And really, it is all about the fact that both companies win when they collaborate, because obviously Bitstack, being a new exchange, being the new kid on the block, needs the backing and reputation and technology from Bittrex. And Bittrex needs new customers. They really need to expand their ecosystem. And really, when you have an order book that is joined, both exchanges win at the end of the day. So it's all about aligning incentives. It's important to note that one of the most central features of Bitstack is, of course, that they are an IEO platform. And nowadays, you see many exchanges doing IEOs. And the reason for that is that there is a lot of market demand. There are so many projects that want to do IEOs, so many speculators that want to participate in IEOs. And really, you can say that this is the ICO hype 2.0. Not to the same extent, not to the same magnitude, but really look at the bear market and look at how IEOs have really ignited new fire and ignited new interest in different altcoins is significant, no question about that. I think a bigger question is how long it will continue. I mean, will we still be seeing IEOs in 6 months, in 8 months? Because at the end of the day, everything in crypto right now is about cycles. I mean, how much can the IEO cycle continue for? Is it forever? Absolutely not. Is it for several years? Maybe, but probably not. Because the hype is not as big as the ICO hype, and that only continues for a year approximately. So we're going to see that, but still, there's a lot of demand, there's a lot of opportunities in the market. As we mentioned, they are collaborating a lot with Bittrex, so they will be sharing the market depth with Bittrex. They will be also giving you access to all cryptocurrencies and markets from Bittrex. So really, it is Bittrex and Bitstack in one exchange. Really, you get all the benefits of being on Bittrex, but Bitstack is going to have its own perks, is going to have its own loyalty program, is really going to expand to other markets. And in many ways, it is like, you know, these big brands having a lot of other brands underneath them. So I think you can kind of think of it like that, that Bitstack is another brand, but they do have close ties to Bittrex. And really, it's all about capturing more users, it's all about capturing new markets, and all about capturing new audiences that Bittrex might be struggling with. And of course, there are two separate companies as well. Do not get that wrong. There is quite a bit of separation, but also a lot of collaboration between those two companies. Something else that is important to note is the fact that they do have strategic partnerships with NGC. So this is quite exciting. You can check in the description this article from Yahoo Finance. And it's all about the fact that NGC has invested in BQQQ, which is the coin and token of Bitstack. Kind of like Binance Coin is the coin of Binance, BQQQQ is the is the coin of Bitstack. Let me know, guys, if you can pronounce this. I have some trouble saying BQQQ, but that is how it is, unfortunately. You cannot have everything in life, guys. Sometimes you have to stick with BQQQ. That's a very important thing. And another important thing thing is that they do have another investment in terms of Consensus FinTech Group, also can be found in the description. Some other updates is that they are now announcing their first IEO, and you need to be holding BQQQ tokens for that. It's gonna be Medilot, and read the update right here if you want to learn more. It's gonna be happening soon, and it's all about showing what Bitstack can do. I mean, how can Bitstack really leverage their platform as an IEO platform? I think Medilot will show a lot how it will perform. I mean, is Bitstack viable for other IEOs? Is Bitstack not viable? I think they really need to nail this one in order to have success in the future. So they write, since the official launch of Bitstack Launchpad, we've received applications from over hundreds of projects. No doubt about that. I mean, there are so many projects wanting to do a token sale. After a thorough review of the applications, we're excited to announce the launch of second IEO. So, you know, stay tuned. Not exactly sure when it's gonna happen. In other news, we also have a video on Oh Hey Matis channel about Bitstack. So check that out if you're interested, also in the description. And it's all about being, you know, an Asian global facing crypto exchange. Check it out. And finally, a few days back on June the 20th, we had the news that now you can deposit your candy. Now, many people asked about this candy during this live stream I had with the CEO. People were asking us, hey, when can you deposit the candy? I've asked the CEO several times when people can do it. At that time, he could not really answer, but now deposits have opened on June the 20th, so they should already be open, and now you can deposit your candy. So if you have that, this is really your chance to do something with it. Anyway, guys, I hope you